When a major brand like AMD has to issue a detailed statement on why the performance data its engineers offered differs from what reviewers measured, you quickly understand that something is wrong. According to AMD, the 24H2 update for Windows 11 significantly improves Ryzen gaming performance, and several sites and YouTube channels claim notable gains. This triggered me to thoroughly test the currently best gaming processor, the AMD Ryzen 7 7800 XT, and compare 23H2 versus 24H2 game data. I use a powerful NVIDIA RTX 4090 for all tests to ensure the CPU is the bottleneck at low resolutions, not the GPU. Also, the drivers I used differ because the 23H2 benchmarks were taken several months ago. It is not easy to test all these games fully on numerous settings. It requires countless hours, and I don't fully trust automatic test suites with bots. Everything was done manually by playing the games. To monitor power consumption and every other important aspect of the system, I will use PowerNetics version 2. I benchmark 12 games in 3 resolutions, HD, QHD and UHD, and all possible settings. I run at least 4 measurements per game setting resolution. According to this table, I conducted the following game test sessions in total. HD 152 tests, QHD 152 tests, and UHD 152 tests. I didn't count the retest sessions in the above data to double check some results, which were close to 100 more tests. So we are talking about more than 550 tests in total. There is also the reboot delay between each game and the process idle task command before each game run to ensure that any pending idle task won't bother the CPU. The process idle tasks command can make a notable difference in FPS results in HD resolutions. Raster results. Alan Wake 2, Assassin's Creed Mirage, Cyberpunk, Dead Space, God of War, Hogwarts, Ratchet & Clank, Resident Evil, Starfield and The Last of Us. In HD resolution, the difference is close to 4.5% and it doesn't favor the 24H2 update. So, I can't help but wonder where the performance boost that AMD promised is. In QHD, the performance gap between 23H2 and 24H2 is low. In 4K, the performance gap between the two Windows updates is low. Raster and DLSS, Assassin's Creed, Starfield, The Last of Us, there is no performance increase with only DLSS enabled. Ray tracing, Alan Wake 2, Avatar, Cyberpunk, Dead Space, Forza, Hogwarts, Ratchet & Clank and Resident Evil. With ray tracing enabled and without DLSS, the 24H2 loses notably at HD, where the CPU's performance matters the most. Ray tracing and DLSS, Alan Wake, Avatar, Cyberpunk, Dead Space, Hogwarts, Ratchet and Resident Evil. There is a significant performance gap in HD and QHD resolutions. Ray tracing plus DLSS plus frame generation. Alan Wake, Avatar, Cyberpunk, Hogwarts and Ratchet and Clank. There is around a 5% performance difference at HD and close to 3% at QHD, always in favor of the previous Windows Update version. The differences in rendering are small, with 23H2 winning. This evaluation took me almost a week of testing because I conducted several game benchmarks repeatedly to ensure everything was in order. Moreover, it took me quite some time to gather and analyze all the data although I have prepared some special Python scripts for this purpose. Again, I wanted to be extra sure of all the results, so I did lots of manual checking. As you can see in this table, the total improvement that the 24H2 offers once paired with an AMD processor is negative, meaning that you don't get any actual performance upgrade. So, I can't help but wonder why AMD states the opposite. Of course, the performance differences between the 23H2 and 24H2 has to do with the games that you will select, but doesn't make much sense to go with older and less popular titles. The games I used for comparison purposes cover almost all popular game engines, providing a vast insight into what is going on with the AMD statements about a notable performance improvement with the 24H2 Windows update. Not only did I not see this improvement, but I also noticed an overall performance drop. You might notice a performance improvement in some specific titles and under some conditions that have to do with the game settings, but this is not the case for most titles I tried. So, whoever rushed to back up AMD's claims for a significant performance increase with this Windows update should check twice and not rush to post results confusing users. In my 7800XTD Revisit review, a viewer commented that my results were out of date and that I should check with the 24H2 update, although it is not available yet. I know that on the internet everyone has an opinion, especially when he writes anonymously, but I can't help it and get pissed when I read such stupid and unfair comments about my work. This pushed me to proceed with today's article and offer you a complete insight into what you should expect from the 24H2 update.